Look both ways.
Earl was beginning to know the store and its surroundings like the back of his hand. The Seeker had sought.
Right, where do I need to go? I have a map. Oh shit, I pushed the left, right trigger. Don't want to drive into that. Where do I need to go? Alright, so it shows where I am on the map. The turn on icon thing is kind of in the way. It's right where the square is, the diamond. So I need to go to... Where did he say again? Let's go right. Where's this place? Oh, shit, no. Sorry, I accidentally pushed A. This loading kind of breaks immersion a bit. Whose house is this? Blais? Oh, house. Is this where I need to go? I can't remember. Here, let's take a look. For some reason, I can't look at my journal while I'm in the car or the truck. So, journal.
Carl, ever diligent in his work, always carried his log on him, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations.
Alright. Hamilton's murder. See if any of these names ring a bell. That's all I have right now.
A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot.
Alright, there's nobody in here. New journal entry. Police had disclosed that the body had been desecrated. Today, the official version is that it was partly devoured by beasts, hence the original assumption that a crime had been committed. Alright. So, I'm here to solve a murder, basically. Somebody killed my employer. Keys.
The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clutze et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts.
Someone ran out of time packing his luggage. Attached wire. I don't have one.
Money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies.
This is just like a long dark, just looking through all the cupboards, looking for food. Cigarettes, nice. Paper.
A pay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Clutze et Fils.
So we're like connecting dots by just like the things that we find in somebody's house. Whoa. Hockey sticks, that's Canadian. Montreal Canadiens. Somebody left the TV on. drawing. Le Monster. Impossible creation for a mechanical drawing toy.
The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here?
Looks like they ran, like they packed their bags really fast, probably because of the storm. Only the tormented mind smoke in bed. Or somebody was trying chasing after them. Louise's diary. I fear the worst for Alexander. He hardly gets any sleep. I thought it was the work, but it seems to be far worse than that. From dusk till dawn, he stares into the void. He barely speaks to me. His son asked him to play the ball, and he didn't say a word. In that way, he was to glance at the window. Last night, I heard him mumble in his sleep. He's coming, he murmured. Jeez. I don't know why, but those words left a deep impression on me. He woke up shortly after, covered in sweat. He couldn't remember his dream. Obviously, he didn't go back to sleep after that, chain smoking the night away over the window. He told me to pack my things this morning. I wonder why. Does he himself know we're waiting, but for what? I think I feel dread. Oh. Turn the lights off. What is that? Oh shit. What is that? It's like a yellow circle. All right. I think I remember this. Something's in here. A wolf? Take a picture of that. Can I zoom in? I guess I can't keep it. It's right there. Scare it off. Some meat and beer.
The picture had been taken inside the house. It was the same wallpaper. Judging by the smiles, nobody suspected the impending misfortunes. Little Martin Blais with his uncle Pierre. There was a deep sense of bonding and pride coming out of the picture. Carl felt sorry for the man. No one deserved such a cruel fate.
His furniture has been moved several times. Oh. What the hell is this? Notes from Martin Blais. My sweet Mary, please excuse my handwriting. I am in a hurry. Lives in a very big house in North Manistan. You would be welcome there. I must go now. Quite literally, your friend Martin. All right.
Now we know where the spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless, still, it found its way into many Quebecois home.
All right, so I found a key. I found out a few things about Mr. Pierre. And their home is, like, messed up. So they obviously left in a hurry. We don't know why yet. Oh, fill up bottle. Water bottle. So, yeah, let's go check out the garage, if I can, or that little building right there. Or little shack. Oh man, I don't have the key. Right there. Reach object.
Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key.
All right, so I could use the string that was in there, but I need a magnet, and I don't have a magnet or a string, so I need to go find that. So let's skip this area for now. I'm not even sure if I was supposed to be here for... I was supposed to head here first. Get the hell out of here. Can barely tell where to go. Wait, I'm gonna take a look in his, mailbox. Maybe there's something in there. Continue going this way. All right. Landslide. Let's take a look at this car.
The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone? Someone had been playing with a crossbow here. A very dangerous game. A bolt could hit someone's tire, or their eye. It could even kill someone if the aim was right.
Keep the picture. Sure.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Nothing in there. Alright, I think I remember this part. He went over here.
Oh. Someone must have dropped this in a hurry. But whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in.
The manual owner seems to be Wilford Roy. Alright, I think I'm freezing to death, but let's go take a picture of this. Well, I can't. Can't keep it. I'll head this way. Follow the wolf tracks. All right.
Carl felt engulfed by a wave of cold, and for a second thought he was fainting.
All right, I remember this part.
All of a sudden, four phantasmagoric figures were fixing their gaze on him. What the hell was going on?
What's up? I'm freezing to death, I gotta get out of here. Alright, I remember that part. Each of those people represent some, like, story thing that you're supposed to find out while exploring the area. So, let's get out of here. Can't go any further, so... And I already went to that one house that's right here. So let's go back to the gas station and use that key that we found. Wait, what the hell is this? There's a pathway over here. Let's drive right past it. The wood lots. Sorry if this Let's Play is like all over the place. This is how the game is supposed to be.
An axe.
Got an axe.
Not too shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself. It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Who quits a game one step away from victory? The leftover food, the clothes, the general warmth of the place, no evidence of escape. Carl was sure of it. People were here not long ago, and they expected to come back.
All right, there's not much here. I found a hatchet at least. Let's go drive down this road here. Why is my vision like that? It's like all blurry and shit. Am I like freezing or what's going on here? Whoa. I'll go explore that on my way back. Is it not like warm enough in the truck? There's a smoke over here.
The crossbow bolts had the same origin. Carl was sure of it. Who was it? And more importantly, what was being hunted like this? Without a single window to brighten things up, the inside of the cabin was almost pitch black. Beware of close encounters of knee and furniture.
Alright, so in order to, like, actually warm up, you need to be near a fire. So I was thinking that being in the truck was good enough, but apparently it isn't. So you need to, like, keep yourself warm.
Solitaire. A card game only hermits can truly enjoy. Carl felt depressed at the thought of playing this.
Duct tape. More wood. Suitcase with clean clothes. What's in there? Nothing. The toothbrush is still wet.
Everything was set up for a well-deserved snack. It seemed like the place hadn't been empty for long, but without knowing exactly why, Carl had the feeling no one was coming back anytime soon.
It's like somebody just left in a hurry. All right. Now that I'm warm, found everything that's in this building. Let's go. Let's go take a look at this shack, or this house over here. It's a bit of a walk, but we'll be alright. Oh, I got it.
Welcome to Alibaba's Cave, Lumberjack Edition. Surely Carl would find something worth his time in here.
A chainsaw? It'd be too cumbersome to carry around. Matches. A magnet. Carl's inventory's full. use the magnet, and then all I need is the wiring now. Oh, I can go back to the place, because I think that's all I needed was the wire, or the magnet, to use the, whatever, the wiring thing. To Paul and Jean-Pierre, don't forget to return the key for the cabin if you haven't used it. Thank you. Your supervisor, P.S. the next bus for, I don't know, will be October 12th. Next one is 2 weeks later. Alright, got a key. Forest cabin key. I need to get rid of some stuff in my inventory. Empty bottle. Oh. Inventory. Sherry wine. There. Get rid of one of those. There. A hammer. Nice. Getting all this equipment. I'm rolling in it. What's that? Hardware. Flare. Alright. So let's go back to Pierre's house. Nothing under there? No. Alright, let's go. Before I freeze to death. I should build a fire here. Oh, I can't. Alright, let's go. I kind of wish there was something that would kind of gave you a hint of what you're supposed to do. Oh, turn. Because if I haven't played this before, I would be so lost right now. Like, some of this stuff is coming back to me. Like, I remember this place. But everything else is still fuzzy. Alright. Attach wire. Now I got a wired magnet. Let's go grab that key.
A key? What could it be for? The garden shed?
Yep.
Carl couldn't reach it with his arm alone, but he had more than a few tricks up his sleeve to pick it up.
The chainsaw doesn't work. A lot of flares. I think he used those to fight off wolves, just like in the long dark. Inventory's full. Hammer. Maybe if I didn't go to that one building, maybe that's where I would have gotten the hammer. I should grab that, so I'm gonna go drop some stuff off. Truck's right there. I could just grab the chainsaw and put it in the back of the truck. Beer. Oh, so it's like a weight thing. So these. There isn't like a number of items that you can carry, it's based on weight. Hatchets. Empty gas can, I'll go in there. Smokes. I think that's good. Just in case I need more hardware. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. It's not like Resident Evil where you have to look at a specific spot to find the secret. Alright, cool. Let's go back to the gas station.
Milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit.
Hmm. Do I have the key for this? Yeah. Oh, nice, a gun?
A murder weapon. What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky.
All right.
Everything made sense now. Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spy.
All right, I missed this. Apparently, I think I found a key while I was rummaging through the garage and the store. And yeah, I was supposed to come out here and look at the mailbox and then open up the mailbox and then find the revolver and this note. So I was supposed to find this first, I'm thinking. That's why I was like, what the hell, what the hell is going on? And yeah. All right, so let's read this letter from Hamilton. It is a citizen of Her Majesty and the free economic chambers of the world that I must address what follows to the proper authorities. The worst is happening at this very moment. I cannot write at length, but I am requesting immediate help from my country. I believe the free world is in grave danger. A member of my community, the Honorable. Jeez.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
Alright, I have a gun. I found a gun in that note. Oh yeah, I wanted to use one of the keys for one of these. No, it's not one of those. Alright. We found something. A revolver and a note. Now that we have the gun, the murder weapon, let's go over here. Let's go left this time. Sketchy bridge. I wouldn't drive on that. Actually, I probably would, but whatever. Medical house. Medical place. Let's go here. Alright. Let's get out of here. Dr. Beaupre. Key. Clinic's key. Nope. There's a note on the wall.
There should be a law forbidding doctors from falling sick.
Medical emergency in town. The doctor there is sick. I'll be back soon. If he dies, I won't be returning. I'll have to replace him.
In spite of Dr. Beaupre's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office. It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop.
It's an urn. Isabel. View.
For the one-eyed, or for other vision problems, the eye patch was the way to go.
I don't need to attach the wire, I already got one.
The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock.
His wife.
Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes. Was it Dr. Beaupre, who had hit him head on at the village border?
His wife died, probably. I never did quite catch her name. The men called her Lori. She had a neck wound. There was so much blood, the bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless, hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The men had found her like this, they said. I doubt it. But in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. I've told to step back from sending out the death certificate. This whole thing sickens me. No medical explanation whatsoever could be explained why old Razer is still alive. As we in the trade say, the only way to cure him is to kill him.
Doctors used light-reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavities. That was a bit unsettling, but back then, it was pretty much always the case with medicine. A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time. And even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book?
Maybe...
Nobody kills a rich patient to start a revolution. It didn't make any sense. He had to dig deeper still to understand. Luckily, that was Carl Faubert's specialty.
Great. All right.
A chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
Store in a cool with a constant temperature, they said. Earth doesn't look this big from here. The doctor is apparently fascinated by history.
Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident.
Or shot in the neck.
In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead.
I can barely see that. Might as well keep it. This kind of reminds me of INFRA taking pictures of all the damage to the building. My nightmare.
Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict. Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office.
All right, so I looked through everything in this building. I think there's anything I have to move around or explore further.
Dr. Beaupre had done his medical studies quite far from here. He was surely one of the first students out of the new campus to settle on the mountainside. The injured could be recognized by the large stains of red, an informal nickname given to Merbromen, smudged all over their injuries.
Lantern. All right. All right, let's take a look at our journal. Maybe it'll give us some clues on what to do next.